They are congregating in Toronto in anticipation of game one of the Leafs and Bruins. We will take you there immediately after our coverage. Meanwhile, as we ship off to Boston, a fitting look for Austin Matthews and the boys as they get set to face their arch nemesis in Boston. Game one, Bruins, Leafs.
We have been waiting for this series since like Christmas.
Yeah, you basically knew it was going to happen in and around Christmas the way Tampa was playing.
So odd, but we are here now. Brian Burke is there in the CBC building. He is joining us ahead of a busy hockey night. Brian, great to see you, sir. Are you excited? You jacked? What are the feelings right now?
I am. Last night was great. The playoffs are the best time of the year, and the first round is usually the most exciting. Multiple games every night, just fantastic. Last night was great. Tonight will be just as good.
Overhyping a game one happens a lot, Brian. But is that possible with the history that the Leafs and the Bruins have? Is this game that important on a lot of levels for the Leafs?
Well, I think, first off, we got to mention Providence College, my alma mater, is playing University of Minnesota Duluth right now, scoreless after one. I have a bet with Tom Curvers, who was a Bulldog. I'm going with the Friars. I don't think game one is critical. I think game one is important in terms of tone. I expect Boston to try and set the tone for the series. And it's important, I think, that Toronto respond to the tone, the hitting, the finishing checks, the getting in the way. So that's number one. If they lose the game, it's not the end of the world. I think they need to get a split in Boston. I believe they're going to. I don't know if they're going to win tonight. This series is going to be a lot tougher than a lot of people think it is. People are talking about sweeps. You got to be kidding me.
I won't tell you that Cicero whispered to me, I got UMass. I'll just leave that out of the mix. They're taking on Denver in the other semifinals.
They're on the other side, yeah. I got a bet on that game, too. Right, Tom McClellan's kid plays for Denver, and I got a bet. Right. If they meet Providence in the finals, we got to bet a nice bottle of wine.
Nice. All right, let's continue on the conversation on the Leafs and the Bruins, though. And for me, I looked at both of the goaltenders, and neither of them really finished that well. Tuukka Rask, unbeknownst to a lot of Leaf fans, really struggled down the stretch. And Frederik Andersen didn't exactly turn the lights out on anybody. How do you figure goalies going into the postseason? Is there any way, or is there just a flip of a switch?
I think these stats are really misleading. I think both teams stumbled to the finish line. And I think Freddie Andersen had to make his save percentage dip to like 870 or something, but he was facing shots that good teams don't give up. My big fear for the Leafs is they were so dysfunctional in terms of their structure and their special teams down the stretch that Freddie Andersen and Garrett Sparks had to make some huge saves. So I don't fault the goaltender. When he's got to on a degree of difficulty, if 10 is the most difficult, if he's seeing 6 to 8, 10 grade shots a game, I don't fault the goaltender if 3 or 4 of them go in. So to me, the goaltender, and same with Boston, they lost a bunch of games on the way out too. I don't fault the goaltenders when they're getting an unfair amount of quality chances. So if I'm going into this, if I'm the Toronto Maple Leafs, Freddie's the third or fourth of my worries. Number one would be my defense. Number two would be my special teams, which haven't been in sync. And number three would be my preparation, my establishment of a playoff-style team.
I have to ask you, as we go into this series, given your history, could this series be a referendum on skill without much toughness and whether or not that can be successful in the postseason?
Well, it would have to be more than this series for that to be a referendum that's successful, but it's certainly going to be... I think both teams are highly skilled. One plays with a little more sandpaper than the other. And last year, the final four teams were all teams that had some weight. So I think if you look at the sample size of one series, you could say, well, skill can eclipse grit and sandpaper any day. But the fact of the matter is, if you look at the Stanley Cup champions the last few years, Pittsburgh's kind of an exception, but they have had some size and weight to them. And last night, they played long pants hockey, all five series. There was lots of banging last night. That was hard hockey last night. That wasn't skill. They were finishing everything. They were hitting hard in all the games, and I expect the same tonight.
Yeah.
All right, let's go to the game after the Leafs and the Bruins tonight, Avs and Flames. It has been a long time since Calgary have been the top seed in that Western Conference, 1989 to be exact. What is the most important thing, Berkey, if you're Bill Peters, to tell your team before going out there tonight?
Well, number one, I think they've got to get the big line going. The big problem over the last stretch of games was the big line didn't produce. and then that Bill Peters broke them up, then put them back together again. They've got to produce if this team's going to make a run. At the same time, Philip Grubauer has been so unconscious the last 10 games, they've got to be patient too. They can play a great game tonight and not score in the first 40 minutes, and they tend to get frustrated when that happens. You see them banging their sticks and cursing as they go off the ice. They've got to stay with the program here. If they got to pick a team to play in the playoffs, and no one will say this from the Flames, but if they were allowed to pick a team in the West to play in the first round of the contenders, this would have been the team they picked. I think they should beat this team. I like Colorado. I like their coach immensely. Their goaltending might be the difference, but the Flames should be able to, if they keep the gas pedal down to the floor, they should be able to do this.
Is this why Mike Smith was acquired?
Well, I think, you know, there's a lot of people. That's a great question. A lot of people are talking about the goaltending controversy. I don't see one. The key here is if Mike Smith can stop the puck, which he has the last little bit, and I believe in Mike Smith, if he can stop the puck, the other dimension he gives them is crazy. It's like they have three defensemen dressed. Their defenseman will not get hit half as often or half as hard if Mike Smith plays because he gets to so many loose pucks and moves it. It's like having a third defenseman. So if he can stop the puck, which I believe he will, and then he gives them that added dimension, man, oh, man, they're in great shape. And if they have to go to the second goalie, they're like the Boston Bruins if they got to go to Halak. They've got a good option if they have to go to the second goalie, but I don't think you'll see the second goalie anytime soon.
We've got about a minute here, Berge. How much hockey are the Flames going to be playing over the next little bit? How far can they go?
Well, right now, I think they've outplayed just about everyone in the West. I could see them coming out of the West. I didn't pick them to because of their lack of playoff experience. The one thing they don't have is experience. And if you look at the teams that have had success recently, Washington, Tampa, Boston, these are all teams that had playoff success, playoff experience. The one aberration of that would be Las Vegas. But even then, even though they were a new team, a lot of their players had playoff experience. So that's why I'm not picking the Flames to come out of the West. That's the only reason. Can they? Absolutely.
Good luck to your Providence. All the best to them.
Still scoreless.
All right. So a lot of hockey left to be played there, Berkey, and a lot of broadcasting for you to be done this evening. Leafs Bruins coming up very soon here on Sportsnet, followed by the Flames and the Avs. Have fun, sir. Thank you.
Thanks for having me on.